Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 2 whole numbers, and in that we have already finished with the first introductory exercise 2.1, in which we have done predecessor, successor, addition on number line, subtraction on number line, then multiplication on number line. And related to that only we have finished with exercise 2.1, and after that we had started properties of whole number. Since we have done first three properties of whole numbers, first is closure property. What does that closure property means? If you will add two whole numbers, the result which you will be getting, that is again a whole number. Then we have done multiplication of whole number. If you multiply two whole numbers, the third number or the product which you will get it, that is again a whole number. After that we have done commutative property. Again, commutative property, in any order you can do addition of two whole numbers. A plus B is equals to B plus C. What does it mean? That you can add two whole numbers in any order. After that we have done multiplication of two whole numbers, which is again a commutative property, and we can say that whole numbers are commutative under addition and multiplication. Now whole numbers are commutative under addition and multiplication means we can add two whole numbers in any order as well as in the multiplication also. We can multiply two whole numbers in any order, but the result is same. Then we have done associative property. Now what does this associativity of whole numbers says? That we can add three whole numbers in any order, or it goes with the multiplication also. We can multiply three whole numbers in any order. After that, we have done few examples that is related to closure property, commutative property, and associative property. Now, children, today I am going to start the class with the fourth property, that is distributive property. Now, if I take name of this property, the whole name of this property is distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now what does it mean, that distributive property of multiplication over addition? Now distributive property of multiplication over addition says that if we'll multiply a number with the sum of two numbers, we'll get the same answer. If I'll multiply the first number with the second number and first number with the third number and adding their result. So what does it mean? First of all, the fourth property where we were doing, there only you will write this fourth property, distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now this is your fourth property, that's why only I have written here four. And along with that we will be going to see rest of the things also. Now what does this property says? A multiplied by B plus C is equal to A multiplied by B plus A multiplied by C. Now distributive property of multiplication over addition says that if we multiply the first number in the sum of second and third number, is always equal to, if we multiply first and second number and adding that product into the product of first and third number. So that is your distributive property. A plus B, A multiplied by B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. So that is your distributive property of multiplication over addition. We often use these this property in your questions. How we are going to use this property in the question? That if you have been given with such kind of a question, if I'll take it, 4 into 5 plus 8. If I'll take this in example, and if I'll open this, I'll write it like this, 4 into 5 plus 4 into 8. 4 into 8. Now what I'll get it on this left side, I'll get it here 4 multiplied by 8 plus 5, that will be 13. And here 4 5s will be 20 plus 8 4s are 32. Now what I'll get it on this side, 13 4s are, that will be 52. And here also I'll get the sum, that is 52. It means that whatever property which we have done, that property follows the same in the question also. Here I have taken one question where the value of A is 4, B is 5 and C is 8. And I have to check this property only, that is distributive property of multiplication over addition. So I put that value in this question and then I multiplied for A into B plus A into C. And after the multiplication and then we have added. Here you can see that on LHS on left hand side I'll get that 52 only, and on the right hand side it shows that this distributive property of multiplication over addition goes with different question also. See, if I'll have such kind of a question, how we are going to solve this? We are going to solve this question like this only. Fine, again we will take it, like we can take one more example. If I change the example here, we can take it one more example to understand this distributive property. Let's take 6 multiplied by 7 plus 9. So how we can find it out? Its product 6 into 7 plus 6 into 9. So this question you have been given with, and I have opened this question by using this distributive property. So exactly what is the use of these property? That for doing multiplication or for solving any equation, directly you can use these property. Okay, so now 6 sevens will be 42 plus 6 nines are 54. Do the addition here, that will become 96. Here on this side also you will be getting the same answer. So 96 is the answer. And if it is asked in the question that which property you are using in this question, so you will write distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now how will you remember, how will you able to know in the question that we were using this property? If you remember, in associative property you were having three numbers. But there you are having only, either you have addition or you have multiplication. Inside it, if you have multiplication outside, so inside it also you have multiplication. If outside you have addition, then inside also. So only one sign is there. But in this distributive property, you will find it out that we have multiplication over addition. Over addition means both the sign you will get it in the question. Multiplication also. And addition also, both the sign you will get it in this question. Multiplication also and addition also. So children, this is the way to find it out that which property you are going to use in the question. And if you have to write the name of that property, that also you can easily write it down. Commutative property, two numbers with addition or multiplication sign. Associative property, three numbers either with addition or with multiplication. But distributive property, three numbers of distributive property of multiplication over addition. Then what we have? Then we have closure property. Closure property says that if you will multiply two whole numbers, you will get the third answer is again a whole number. Then we have one more property that if you divide the number, whole number, the same whole number divided by the other same whole number, you will be getting one as an answer, identity property. And then zero division, if zero is divided by any whole number, you will be getting zero as an answer. So these property, we have finished with all the properties of whole numbers. Now I am going to take it example 5. Now example 5, already till example 4 we have done yesterday. Example 5. Now the school canteen, that is application based question. And application based question, how you will use these property to solve application based question. Now example 5 says that the school canteen charges rupees 20 for lunch and rupees 4 for milk for each day. How much money do you spend in 5 days on these things? Now it is asked in the question that cost of lunch is rupees 20 per day and cost of milk is 4 rupees per day. Now the first method is you will find it out cost of a lunch for 5 days, that is 5 into 20, that is rupees 100, and cost of milk for 5 days, that is 5 into 4, that is rupees 20, and after that you are going to find it out total cost. This is one of the method. Fine. So example 5 will understand, and after that we are going to come to the next question. And then we are going to see the exercise also, how we will be using these property in the exercise. Fine. So what does this example 5 says? Already we have finished with all the example, that's why I am taking this example 5 also, and after that I will come to that exercise. Example 5, what does it say? That the school canteen charges rupees 20 for lunch and rupees 4 for milk. Now children, one method is you will find it out cost for lunch, then cost of milk, and then you will add it. So this is the traditional method which we are already using in each question. Now one more method is there, that you will add cost of lunch and milk for one day and then cost for 5 days that you can find. Okay, so I'll go with this second method. Why? That I'll tell you just now. Cost of lunch and milk. Lunch and milk for one day. For one day. One day. That is rupees 20 plus rupees 4. Now cost of lunch for 5 days. Cost of lunch for 5 days. Now what I can do it, that the cost for one day, that will be multiplied by 5. So I can write it like this. 5 will be multiplied by 20 plus 4. Do you remember this we have done just now? What we have done just now, we have done distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now what we were doing, cost of lunch and milk for one day, that is rupees 20 plus rupees 4. Now cost of lunch for 5 days, what will be the cost of lunch for 5 days? What I'll do it, 5 will be multiplied by to the sum of lunch and milk for one day, that is 5 multiplied by 20 plus 4. So what I will get it here, I can do it this, 5 will be multiplied by 20 plus 5 will be multiplied by 4. Now here I am using this distributive property to solve it. 100 plus 5 volts will be 20. So rupees 120 is the total cost for 5 days, that you will write it in the formula. Therefore rupees 120 is the total cost for 5 days. Total cost for 5 days. For 5 days. So what we have seen just now, we have done one property, that is distributive property of multiplication over addition. And this example 5 is related to that property only, and how we will use that property in application based question. Many of times I have heard from children that there is no use of studying that, where we were using this this distributive property in our daily life, or this commutative property in our daily life, or how we were using associative property. So these application based problem will tell you that condition, or that set an example that where you are using this distributive property, associative property. And meanwhile, I'm going to explain few more examples or application based question. There you were using associative property also, the commutative property also. So let's see this example once again, and after that I'll move to the next. Now what was the question? That the cost of lunch for one day is rupees 20, and cost for milk, that is rupees 4 for one day. Now you are supposed to find it out what will be the cost of lunch and milk for the 5 days, for the next 5 days. So what I'll do it, that cost of lunch and milk for one day, that is rupees 20 plus 4. Here you can write only 20 plus 4 also. That is understood, that cost means that is given in rupees only. After that, cost of lunch and milk for 5 days. Cost of lunch and milk. And milk for 5 days. And milk for next 5 days. So 5 will be multiplied by 20 plus 4. Do the multiplication, 5 will multiply it by 20, 5 will multiply it by 4. What you will be getting? 100 plus 20. Now rupees 120 is the total cost for 5 days. Now which property we have used in this question? Just now we have done distributive property, and that same property we have been used in this question. So children, let's take one more example. Now sometimes you will be given such examples where that is mentioned that use this property in this question. You will be getting some of the question in your book that you have been mentioned with that which property you are supposed to use in that question. Like we have this example 6 in your book. What is that? Find 12 multiplied by 35 by using distributivity. By using distributivity. Distributivity. So what does it say is that how you will use this distributive property in this question, 12 multiplied by 35. So what I'll do it here, that I can write this 12 multiplied by 35 in this way. 12 multiplied by 35, I can write it down in this way. I can write it 12 multiplied by 30 plus 5. Now, I have used this distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now I'll expand it. 12 multiplied by 30 plus 12 multiplied by 5. Now 12 threes are, that will be 36. 12 threes are, that will be 36. 360 plus 12 fives are 60. What is the sum? That will be 420. This will be your answer for this question. Now in this question, in this whole question, I have used this distributive property. Just now we have done also. So what you are supposed to do it, that whenever you have to use these distributive property, you will expand any one from these number, means 12 multiplied by 30 plus 5. सिंस डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी इज द प्रॉपर्टी इन विच यू वर डूइंग एडिशन और मल्टीप्लीकेशन ओवर एडिशन मीन्स यू रिक्वायर्ड मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑल्सो यू रिक्वायर्ड एडिशन ऑल्सो आफ्टर दैट आफ्टर राइटिंग इन दिस वे देन आई विल एक्सपैंड इट ए इंटू बी एंड ए इंटू सी विद दिस एडिशन साइन एंड देन विल डू दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड देन वी विल एड इट Now that is your example 6. Now if you will see in your book, you will find it out certain questions that is related to this distributive property only. You will getting a certain question in which you have to use this distributive property. I'll take few more examples so that this distributive property is clear to you all. Now these are general examples. Now in which you are using distributive property. So first, already example 6 I have done. Now I am taking few more questions. That is not example 6 but that is related to distributive property. So I will take it this 15 multiplied by 68. Now if this question will be given that find 15 multiplied by 68 by using distributive property by using distributive property. So let's find it out. First of all, I have to write it in by expanding it. So we'll expand it. I can write it in this way 60 plus 8. So now this become distributive property of multiplication over addition. Now I'll expand it 15 multiplied by 60. Plus 15 multiplied by 8. So 15 6s are, well, that will be 90, 900 plus 8 5s are 44, 120. Now what I can do it? Now I'll add it, both these numbers, that will become 1020. This will be your answer. This will be your answer. So what we have done, we have used this distributive property of multiplication over addition. First thing, you have to expand any one of from these numbers. You can expand 15 also. Fine, you can expand. But if you will expand 15, then you have to multiply a huge number with that, 10 and then 5. So that's why I have expanded 68 only. Let's take one more example related to that. If you will be having this, 17 multiplied by 23. So what I'll do it, 17 multiplied by 23. Why I am doing all these examples? See, since this distributive property is quite new for you all, since all the properties are only new for you all, but since this property is quite newer for you all, so that's why I'm taking these examples. So 17, first I'll expand this 20 plus 3. I can write it like this 20 plus 3 and after that 17 will be multiplied by 20 plus 17 will be multiplied by 20 and then we have this other one plus 17 will be multiplied by 3. Now 340 plus 3 7s are 21, that will be 51. Then we can do addition, 391. This will be your answer. You can find it out that it is quite simple to find the product of these any two numbers if you are using certain kind of a property. Now children, I'll come to example 7, which is related to simplify. But that simplify, you are not going to use or you are not going to do it. Like earlier, you were doing do product of two numbers. And then if you have been given with addition, then you will do addition and or you will do multiplication or whatever. So example 7 will do it. Example 7. And how we were using the property in solving it, that we will see. Example 7. So let's start with that example 7. Example 7, that is simplify. Example 7 is simplify. Simplify. What is the question? That 126 multiplied by 55 plus 126 multiplied by 45. If you will look at this question very carefully, you will find it out that there is one property in which we were expanding such kind of a question, which property we were using to expand it, certain kind of a question. There is one property in which we were using it. So let's see which property we were using to expand it. So here I can see that 126 into 55, and here also 126 into 45. If you will see the distributive property is this kind only, A multiplied by B and then A multiplied by C. So from these two terms, you can take it out one term that is common in both. What is that? That is 126. We can take it out common, and inside I can write it 55 plus 45. Now what I have done in this question, we have not done anything new. But earlier what is there, you have been given with this part, and this part you are opening it. Now here in simplify you have been given with this part, and you have changed it into this part, A into B plus C. Now if it is asked in the question that simplify this term and which property you are using, so here only in the bracket you will write distributive property. Which property we were using? So I'll write here distributive or distributivity. Distributivity. Fine. I'll write it, and after that I'll do it 126. This 55 plus 45, that will become 100. And the answer you will be getting 126 00, that will be your answer. As you can see that this is an easier method to do simplify, and so easily you all can do it, that simplification. So I hope that is clear to you all, this example 7, how to find it out, how to simplify these. So children, today what we have done distributive property, that is related to your next exercise in which we were doing properties of whole number. Already we have done with closure property, and then we have done commutativity, then we have associativity, and then today we have finished with distributivity or distributive property of whole numbers under addition over under multiplication over addition. So this distributive property we have done, and today we have seen how we will use this distributive property in doing question. Already we have finished with till example 7, in which most of the question that is related to distributivity. Now identity for addition and multiplication, that I'll continue in the next class. How they will do it with 0, how they will do it with 1, how they will perform with their same numbers. So that concept I'll take it tomorrow in tomorrow's session. Till now you all will complete till example 7. Write down all the properties, which I'll make you write it on a separate page. On that separate page you write it out, all the properties. Find closure, commutative, associativity, that you have already done. There only you will write it out, distributivity, and how you will write it out, distributive property or distributivity of whole number is close under addition and multiplication. That only you have to write it. And then example 6, 7, not only 6, 7, 5, 6, 7, that is related to distributivity, that you will do it. So today I'll finish the class here, and we'll meet in the next class. and will continue this concept in that class. So that's all for today, children. Have a good day.